In Japan, we learned that by mixing leaves and other living materials into our soil, we can make farmland more fertile without the need for chemicals. Here at EPCOT, we're learning to reduce the need for chemical pesticides.
Still respect the needs of the land. Some of the answers are being discovered just ahead. To help us maintain these carefully controlled ecosystems, and for your safety, please remain seated in your boat at all times. Welcome to our Glimmering Greenhouses, where scientists from EPCOT and the U.S. Department of Agriculture illuminate the wondrous gifts we receive from the land. Join us as we ring in the most bountiful time of the year. For some, it's difficult to imagine the holidays without winter and snow, but one of the most important holiday crops actually grows in the tropics. For centuries, farmers in Central America have cultivated cacao to make chocolate. In fact, cacao is chocolate's main ingredient. To keep warm with a cup of hot cocoa, thanks to this tropical plant. You might not think of fish, but seafood is an essential part of many festivities. In parts of southern Italy, family and friends gather once a year to celebrate the opportunity of the seven-course seafood dinner. Tilapia, bass, and shrimp, like the ones raised here, using our sustainable water systems, pick up just some of the dishes served during this grand meal. To get people in the United States, the country will not have a host of the seven fish. Citrus, like the oranges grown here, are common in Florida, but in Northern Europe, where fresh fruit is rare in winter, they're much harder to find,
making them an extra special stocking stuffer. During Chinese New Year, these vibrant fruits are given as gifts of good fortune. They say it's better to give than to receive. And in this greenhouse, we're celebrating the holidays by giving back to the land using innovative farming techniques. By recycling water, we can give plants rich nutrients. By giving plants ladybugs, we're able to control pests and reduce the need for pesticides. And by growing ground plants vertically, we give them better protection from disease. With these gifts, our plants can grow an abundance of festive vegetables. This greenhouse alone grows a bountiful 15 tons of produce each year. When we give more, we receive more, making the most of the land's green gifts. Many of the plants you see here help spice up the holiday. The bark of cinnamon trees, like the one growing beside you, is used to make cinnamon sticks. You like eggnog? You can thank nutmeg for its signature taste. Other spices, like ginger and vanilla, add flavor to a variety of holiday cookies, cakes, and other delights. By cultivating these festive plants with care and good cheer, EPCOT scientists are able to celebrate the holidays with the land's many gifts. These greenhouses represent just a fraction of the work being done worldwide to produce bountiful harvests for our growing population. Scientists, farmers, and even backyard gardeners are doing their part to improve the quantity and quality of foods that we all rely on. Together, we can continue to find more ways to increase food production and protect our precious natural environment. Only then will we truly be living with the land.